In this lesson, we are going to see how to calculate the p-value of a one-sample t-test. One-sample t-test is used to see if the mean value of a sample is statistically similar, greater than, or less than a known expected value. This is the formula for the t-variable. This is the mean value of our sample, and this is our sample. This is the expected value. We want to compare the mean value with, and this is the sample variance. N is the number of the points of our dataset. This variable is distributed like a t variable, which follows a t distribution, with n minus 1 degrees of freedom. So we have three cases. The two-tailed case, in which we want to see if the mean value is statistically similar to the expected value, and two one-tailed cases, left tail and right tail. So the first thing we have to calculate is t. So first of all, we have to set a value for me, so the expected value we want to compare our mean value with. For example, let's say we want to compare this value with 3. So, expected value 3. Now we have to calculate all these numbers here. So, mean value is the average of our dataset. The text value will be ignored. Then, sample as standard deviation, it is std dev s, because we want the sample standard deviation, number of points is count . Now we have to calculate the degrees of freedom. This is a parameter of the t-distribution, and it is, according to statistics, the number of points minus 1. Now we are able to calculate the value of t, which is exactly this formula here. The mean value of our dataset, the expected value, then we have the square root of the sample standard deviation squared divided for the number of the points. This is the value of t. Now, let's calculate the p-value related to a one-sample t-test. Particularly, we have to calculate the p-value related to this value of t with these degrees of freedom. Let's start with a two-tailed test. The null hypothesis of a two-tailed test says that the mean value of our dataset is equal to the expected value. So, two-tailed test. Now we have to calculate the p-value. In order to calculate the p-value, we have to use the function t.dist.2t. Two-tailed. The first argument is the absolute value of the t variable, so abs t. The second argument is the number of degrees of freedom, this one. And this is the p-value. As you can see, is very low. If we accept a confidence level equal to 5%, according to this p-value, we reject the null hypothesis, and it is pretty clear why, because this mean value is very different from the expected value, even if we have this sample standard deviation here. So this is how we perform a two-tailed t-test. The function is t.dist.2tails to t, and we have to give the absolute value of the t variable. If we give the t variable when it is a negative number, we get an error. Because this function needs a positive number. Remember that the t-distribution is symmetrical, so we can give the absolute number, the absolute value of the t-variable to this function, and we still have a good value. This is the area that goes from the area of the t-distribution that goes from the absolute value of t to plus infinity, plus the area that goes from minus infinity to the negative version of t, so minus the absolute value. The area of the two tails. If it is lower than our confidence level, we can reject the null hypothesis. So let's cancel this function here. Now we have the one-tailed tests. Let's start with a right-tailed test. So the null hypothesis is that mean value is less than expected value. The function we're going to use is t point dist point rt, right tail. We give the t value with its own sign, and we give the degrees of freedom. As we can see, we have a very high p-value because this value is actually very low if compared with the expected value and considering this sample standard deviation. Now we have the left tail. Mean value is greater than the expected value. It is simply 1 minus the p-value of the right tail case. And of course it is very small. So these are the ways we perform the t-tests of a one sample, only one sample, in Excel. For the two-tailed test, we get the p-value calculated with the two tails, giving to this function the absolute value of t. For the right tail, we have the right tail function, rt. For the left tail, it is 1 minus the right tail. So this is how we perform t-test in Excel. Remember that we have to calculate the t-value according to the statistical formula. So we have to calculate the mean value, the sample standard deviation. Remember, we have to work with the sample standard deviation, the number of points, and the degrees of freedom. Then we have to compare everything with an expected value. For example, if we put the expected value to a value that is similar to this one, for example 0, the two-tailed test has a higher p-value because 0 is very similar to this value here according to this sample standard deviation. So we don't accept the null hypothesis, but we say that there is no reason to reject the null hypothesis. Let's go back to 3 in order to see that this p-value and this p-value here are very low, so we can reject the null hypothesis that says that this mean value is statistically similar to this expected value, and we can reject the null hypothesis that says that this mean value is greater than this expected value. In this case, we have a very high p-value, but again, we don't accept the null hypothesis. We just say that there is no statistical evidence that we can reject it. So this is one possible way to use the t-test for one sample in order to compare the mean value of a dataset with the expected value of a possible population.